Then we've got the CapEx versus the operating expenditure model. Setting up the traditional data center is a capital expenditure model, and running it on the cloud is an operating expenditure model. Well, capital expenditure, like I said earlier, you're going to invest all your money right now versus you lease something so that you pay the operating cost. The only option in the past was companies to lease or to buy the physical premises and to buy infrastructure components, buy the hardware and software components, and start the business, grow the business. That's how it was. It's an initial upfront cost. But the cloud computing provides services to the customers without the significant upfront cost. And it is not just the money that you're saving, but a lot of time as well. One is the capital expenditure model, where you're going to invest all your money in the beginning. The other is operating expenditure model, which is more of a cloud adaptation model. So in the CapEx model, yes, any typical on-premises data center includes the costs such as server costs, like I've mentioned already, storage costs, networking, backup, disaster recovery, archivals, organization continuity, that is disaster recovery or business continuity, data center infrastructure costs, or technical personnel, like the staff that you're going to hire. Some of the areas where you're going to invest money, and there could be many other, but essentially you have to invest the money upfront. Similarly, if you see in the operating expenditure model, it is more of a rent or a lease model, that you're going to lease a cloud-based server like EC2 in Amazon, virtual machines in Azure. You're going to lease the software, whether it is a database or any other application for that matter. Scaling charges, if you just wanted to, as the demand increases, if you increase your capacity, you decrease your capacity, it just changes. Billing at user or organization level for billing optimization, if at all you do any. Right. So there are many benefits of going for the capital expenditure model. And so there are many benefits of going for the operating expenditure as well. But it depends on the scenario. With the capital expenditure, you plan your expenditure, you know your project budget, how much you're going to invest, and the period as well. Your costs are fixed. Okay, but in the operating expenditure model, based on the demand and the growth, your cost, I mean, at the end of the year, your spendings may be unpredictable at times. And this is one of the reasons in the very beginning days of the cloud, the customers have come back from the cloud to on-premises is because of their lack of planning. They were believing blindly that the cloud computing would be a very cost-effective solution, but it is not by default. It is cost-effective only when you plan it. Only when you hire an effective and skilled cloud architect, somebody like you, who is trained in all the directions, not just learning the definitions from the internet. Only then, only such people can design your cloud environment and can move your workloads so that you get the benefits, but not directly by moving your applications without understanding the architecture and the actual cost model of the services.